Are all these units considered one size?
I'm sorry?
Are all the units considered one size?
So, they're, here are the typical floor plans. So, the rear units, they're all 1,040 square feet. And then in the front, typical floor plan, one unit is 975 square feet, the other unit is 1,010 square feet.
My question, all bedrooms or one bedroom or two?
So in this typical floor plan, the front ones are one bedroom plus den. Technically, they're two bedrooms, but we can't call the back room a bedroom because it doesn't have a window.
Getting that?
You said you had two bedrooms?
Well, plus den, no, one bedroom plus den.
One bedroom plus den in the front, and the ones in the rear are two bedrooms.
So the fire hurts you on the second floor, you had a couple of two bedrooms.
So yeah, and then on the second floor, there are two bedroom plus dens. So there are three rooms, just on the second floor in the front of the building.
So what's those big squares in the middle, what is that?
That's a hallway.
What are you talking about?
Where you live, here?
No. What is this?
So that's the living space. So that's for a dining room, living room, your kitchen, so you got an island. It's kind of left unprogrammed.
So I see, so that's kind of the,
it's like an open.
The living space, yeah.
Outside. So there's four units to four, is that?
Correct.
So how many up?
Seven stories of residential.
So what variances you're asking?
So this project requires a conditional use permit to exceed 50 feet in an RC district. And then we are seeking a variance, a rear yard modification, a variance from exposure for these rear units. And I think that's it.
And you're within the code for parking and all?
Correct, yes. In the RC district, the maximum parking is 0.5, and we're well below that.
Anybody else have a question? All right, I guess you can move on to the next.
Couple of, because I was doing double duty in front of this. I think you said main level of planning?
Correct.
And anticipated construction beginning when?
Later this year, the end of the year, like fourth quarter or early next year.
When do you expect your environmental documents to be up?
I'm sorry, the?
When do you expect your environmental documents?
So the environmental document has already been issued. A CAT 32 exemption was issued for the project. I can have the planning, I could have probably forward you the link to the existing.
I don't have email.
Does not have email.
Maybe it's our copy.
Oh, okay. I can leave you a copy.
Does anybody else for this project? Questions? All right, I'll move on.
Thank you.
This is 555 Golden Gate. It's located between Van Ness and Polk on Golden Gate. And the lot is a through lot, and it's adjacent to the SFPC building. You can see it here. It's currently an existing one-story commercial over basement. The zoning, so the lot is 7,900 square feet. It's also in the RC district, in the Van Ness SUD. The maximum height on the site is 130, and there is no max density. It's based on FAR. So the FAR on the site is 7.
That used to be Star's Restaurant.
Yes.
It also was Helsky's Garage.
Oh,
okay.
Those are interesting uses.
Yes.
Mixed uses. So the proposed project is 119 feet tall, 11 stories, 58 units. seven of which would be below market rate units on site, 16 parking spaces, and in a subterranean parking garage, and 1,000 square feet of commercial. On the ground floor, you can see these glass boxes. We're also proposing a pedestrian pathway, pedestrian breezeway, on the ground floor. So you can see that's this middle section, and it will be landscaped in order to connect Redwood Street to Golden Gate. Golden Gate here is on the right-hand side. There's a cafe located in the ground floor of the SFPC building, and there's a daycare. So it creates a nice kind of extension and activation of Redwood Alley. On the top here, you can see the location of the lobby for the residential units. The retail here in the front. This is a section of the building. So Golden Gate Avenue is here on the right-hand side. You can see the basement subterranean garage, the pedestrian pathway, breezeway here, which is, you can see landscape planters, which will be embedded in the floor, and then stairs down to Redwood Alley. This is our typical floor plan. So each floor has six units, the mix of one and two bedroom units. I believe there are 21 bedroom units and 38 two bedroom and 2 3 bedroom units. Two 3 bedroom. And all the units are around an interior light port. And they all receive exposure off of the street, either Redwood Street or Golden Gate Avenue. And this is our roof deck, so it'll be a common open space for all the residents. Additionally, each unit has its own private open space, which we'll show you in the rendering.
What amenities do you have on the roof deck?
We just have planters. Typically, we'll do like a barbecue, outdoor kitchen, some seating and such. And
no garden?
It'll be landscaped. There are planters up there.
For the land, it's for the stormwater system. So it'll be dictated way that SFPC will allow us to put in.
Just as far as our outreach, so we had a community meeting back in December 2014. We met with SFPC, the Superior Court, the C5 Children's School, which is the school that's located on the ground floor of the SFPC building, the Tenderloin Community School, which is located a couple blocks, down Van Ness, I guess, just north of the site.
It's actually on the
in that direction. TNDC, and we're currently in our second round of outreach with neighbors, which is you guys and your neighborhood groups. And we're going to present before the San Francisco Housing Action Coalition later this month. So the current status of the project, we should be out of environmental review in the next couple months, and expect to go to the Planning Commission late summer, I think. So here you can see kind of the private decks that each unit has, and they kind of shift floor to floor.
That's not glass, is it?
Oh, in the front?
Yeah.
Oh, those are they're palm trees. I don't think we're proposing palm trees. It'll be some kind of tree feature required to provide, I think, 3 street trees in the front and 3 in the back.
I think he was talking about the architectural feature.
The glass.
Oh, the glass.
He asked if that was glass or not.
Oh, it is glass.
Is that kind of
It'll meet all the code requirements with the building department. The building department will review it and ensure that it meets all safety requirements in case of an earthquake.
The city planning says you have to have decorative buildings. They're very liberal on the word decorative, but you can't just have a box standing there without looking interesting. So this is why we have such interesting buildings.
Where is the entrance to the garage?
So the entrance to the garage is off of Redwood. I don't have the basement plan, but you can see it on the ground floor, the ramp down.
And well, it's just good because the children have to go up and down.
Also,
well, I mean, we're the cars you it's just better that the entrance be away for the kids that we want to go. So, what has your response, because you said you went to schools, what is your response from the schools?
So, their concerns generally related to construction impacts. So, actually, we were meeting with the C5 school this morning again. The second meeting with them, just kind of update them on our progress and when we thought we might be starting construction, and they said just to keep them, you know, updated and such. The Tenderloin Community School, they had a small concern regarding shadow, potential for our building to shade their play areas, and we had a shadow study conducted as part of environmental review, and there is no impact.
And kind of a weird question to ask, but I'm going to ask it. You aware that obviously that where McDonald's is at, that's going to be going up, and I don't know if you're going to be impacting that in any way. So if it's a truck up to the plate first, and if you put up a shadow, if they can't complain because they don't know what they're going to be doing here, I mean, or have you heard what they're going to be doing here?
I'm not sure what they're going to be doing. I know the initial proposal, I think, was for the senior housing, but I think they're proposing something different right now.
Because there's actually two blocks, there's also another one on Golden Gate, so I'm not sure who's going to be doing that extra one there.
Are you doing a soft foundation or all
It'll just be a mat foundation. I think it's like a 3 to 4 foot mat foundation.
It'll. We're still working through the engineering. I don't know that we're really going to have to do any footings. I don't expect to do pile driving. We might have to do some shoring against the neighboring building, but we're working through the structural engineering right now.
Well, the reason I ask is, I really look in depth into things like liquefaction, groundwater,
right,
and sea level rise. Uh-huh. And that's why I asked every project in the Civic Center area, I asked her to say questions about how the building is being secured to the ground.
Right.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
We've had a geotech go out there and survey the site, and our structural engineer is working with that data.
Can I get a copy of the report?
I'm sure.
I love geotech.
And what was your response from the PUC? I know they have electrical, they do an electrical thing for cars in the front. So would you be somehow interacting with that? Cars.
Is it on the front of their building?
Yeah, there's a meter.
So they haven't raised that concern at all.
It's a whole strip of parking there.
I mean,
it's right, since you're right next door to it.
Yeah, I mean, they welcome the building. You know, they've expressed some concerns regarding construction and impacts, you know, during the construction period, such as noise and such. So we're working with them.
Because their entrance to their building for the employees is right next quarter here.
Okay.
Just saying. I mean, if you sit there and watch what goes on, what goes on and how people get into the buildings.
Yeah.
Has there been any other concerns that been raised? Like how long the construction will be? Because obviously this one's a little bit
bigger.
Bigger.
No concerns that I'm aware of.
Will it impact the studying for these kids? I mean, as far as noise.
The school. So we didn't
even have a Tenderloin school, not necessarily.
You're talking about the.
I don't know what the C5. That's just preschool.
It's a preschool daycare type school. They're located in this building and they're located in the state building that's across the street, across Polk.
Right. So I don't think that there's studying. So the Tenderloin school would have to study.
They might have that time. Had they raised that question?
Well, the Timberland School is actually located a block away, a clear distance. It's, they're across the street, you know, across Elm. You know, we're meeting with them in a couple weeks, and so we'll touch base with their principal and find out if they have any additional concerns.
So there's also...
What's your green status on this one?
It'll be Green Points as well.
And the other thing is... did you do a wind study?
We did do a wind study, and there's no impact. So nothing that's going to be flagged in the environmental review. Yeah, no significant impact. They actually did a whole full-blown wind tunnel study.
The state building just down the street from you did such a horrendous job wind that every time I see a tall building in the same general area, I get all worried that but it's going to impact them, it's going to increase.
Yeah, the Van Ness Special Use District actually has specific requirements about wind at that street level and such, and they analyze all of that as part of the impact study.
So that's the Special Use District, and is just the Van Ness? You're not into the City Center Historical District too?
So there is I don't think we are in the Tenderloin Historic District. I think we're just outside of it.
Civic Center.
So the Civic Center? We are not in a historic district. I think it actually goes just down Redwood.
No, it's like Redwood Avenue.
Yeah, and it's this side of Redwood, and we just have to be on the other side.
So, a few questions. As far as the parking, is there will there be any charging stations, vehicle charging stations?
We have one project that we're currently exploring that,
it's logistics more to make sure we have enough power to the building and that there's space for them to actually charge. So we want to put it in. We're looking at it. It's just more getting the logistics to make sure it works.
Yeah, definitely. It's definitely easier, to do it before you build, as you build, as opposed to,
after retrofitting.
You want to be ahead of the curve.
Yeah, it's something new for us, but we're definitely exploring it.
And kind of along with that, because clearly you don't have enough spaces for every unit, especially in, very dense areas like that, trying to get away from people using it. Is there going to be any car share spaces as well?
So there will be one car share space is required by planning code. So there will be one car share space.
Since you're having, this one seems to be more family oriented, because you have many multiple bedroom units. So will you have storage down in the basement?
We're not proposing any storage. It would just be the parking. We have a lot of building requirements that we're trying to meet, but the project actually requires a water storage for the sprinklers. And so they're, because it's so
but if somebody wanted to stick one of those storage unit boxes in their parking spot, you would allow?
It would be up to the HOA, I think.
Yeah.
But
I mean,
they technically own the space, so yeah.
They can do what they want.
I think that would be up to the HOA's discretion.
And how many BMR?
BMR, there's seven. Yeah. So four two-bedroom BMRs and three one-bedroom BMRs. Storage. The only kind of water storage that we have is associated with the stormwater. So we have I don't know if it's shown here. In addition to these planters that we're providing, there's actually a flow-through planter. It's located on a mechanical mezzanine that's right here.
just above the bike parking.